Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. Brother Patrick Winfrey here in the Philippines, Mindanao Island. Hope you guys are all doing great. Me, doing pretty good. I'm a child of God. I've been redeemed. I'm born of the Spirit of the living God, born from above. You know, I was going to talk about something else. I just want to share something real quick. You know, the Lord's always dropping lots of things on me. You know, there's lots of people that think you need to be water baptized to be saved, and they use this text. Let me clarify it for you just real quick, because the Lord just, I was just looking at this yesterday, and the Lord just quickened it in my spirit from John chapter 3. It says, listen to what Jesus says. You know, one whole story of this is, you know, Nicodemus is talking to Jesus, and it says, it's so funny. I already did teaching on this one. Nicodemus is talking to Jesus, and he says something like, you know, no one can do the miracles you do unless they came from God. So did Jesus say, yeah, you're right, I came from God. Yeah, you're right. No, what does Jesus always do? What does God always do? We can pray. I mean, here's the thing about it. We can pray, and the problem is, as James says, people ask amiss. They ask for something to consume on their own lust, their own desires, instead of praying according to the Spirit of God and the will of God in your lives. And it's not just that God will bless us if we need a car. God will bless us if we need financial help. God will bless us if we need a husband or a wife. It's not, you know, that we just pray, thus as thou us, knowest, didst thou us, about some, you know, spiritual, you know, solemn thing. It's just that we desire things for our, that are not what God's will are. So here is Nicodemus. And Nicodemus is saying to God the Son, the Christ, the Son of the living God, he's saying to Jesus, saying, you know, I know that you had to have come from God, because nobody can do the things you do except for they come from God. What did Jesus do? When you pray, if you're hearing from God, you can pray, you know, Lord, I need a new car. Lord, I don't have a car. Lord, I need a job, blah, blah, blah. Whatever it is you're praying. And the Lord is going to answer you what you need to hear. In other words, you might be praying, you know, Lord, I need a car. And the Lord says, you know, to you, you know, and the Lord makes a way that you need a job first, as an example. He starts talking to you about and giving you the wisdom and idea about some job or something along those lines, or some business or whatever it is. That's what you really need. And maybe even something deeper than that. Maybe you're lacking patience to maintain, to keep from getting fired from your job, or whatever it is. That's what the Lord will speak to you about. Not what you want to hear, but what He wants you to hear. So as an example, when Nicodemus says to Jesus in John chapter 3, it says, he says, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God, for no man can do the miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Well, what is Jesus' response? Yeah, you're right. No, Jesus says to him what Nicodemus needed to hear, not what Nicodemus was talking about. Jesus said, verily, verily, or truly, truly, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. No connection. Jesus started talking about what Nicodemus needed to do. Not about him, what Nicodemus needed to do. So Nicodemus was born as an elite individual there. He was on the Sanhedrin, one of the top 70 leaders in all of Israel. He was a somebody. He was a famous teacher, and he's an important dude there. But yet, the status in which he was born means nothing. It doesn't matter that he was born to some, you know, famous rabbinical family, and that he was some big leader, and that he was so educated, and blah, 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 blah. Jesus said, oh, you need to be born again. See, it's not how you were born the first time, but it's how you're born the second time. It's not where you start life, but where you end life. It's not where you came from, but where you're going. So Jesus said, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. And Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born? And Jesus said, truly, truly, or verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Now, there are people who use that text or are misunderstand it and think it means you have to be water baptized to be saved. That's not what it's saying. Listen to what Jesus does. He gives a comparison. God always does a repeat in the next verse. All those Old Testament poetic writings, like in the Proverbs and Isaiah, it'll say this. It's a Hebraic way of speaking. They will repeat in a different way in the next verse, in the next stanza of the poetic writing, the exact same thing with a different way of saying it. There's thousands of verses like that. I forgot the name of what they call it, but it's a Hebrew form of poetic writing that came from God to reemphasize what you're saying. That, and what does Jesus say in the next verse? That which is born of the flesh and flesh, and that which is born of the spirit is spirit. He's comparing a flesh birth and a spiritual birth. The first birth and the second birth. You must be born again a second time. Jesus said you must be born a second time. You must be spiritually born, born from above. Here it is. So the first birth is of water. Someone who's born as a man on this earth. You cannot enter kingdom of heaven unless you're born on this earth. And then it says, and the spiritual side is you're born again. That which is flesh, and that which is a spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I say to you, you must be born again. He talks about the Holy Spirit. Different story. Brothers and sisters, water baptism, as the Lord had led me the other day, I made a video about this. It is a manifestation, a public display of us being buried with Christ and raised with Him again from the dead. That is what water baptism is, but it does not save you. But Jesus said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. And the Lord commanded that all disciples be baptized, water baptized, to be buried with Christ and resurrected with Him. We identify with Him in burial and resurrection through the public display of our faith in water baptism. That's what it's all about for baptism. But you are not, you cannot take that text and twist it. It's a misrepresentation of this text that I just read to you, John chapter 3, to say that water baptism is required for salvation. That is not true. In Acts chapter 2, the United Pentecostals, as an example, who believe that Jesus and the Father are really, Jesus prayed to Himself, that there's no Trinity, that there's only one God always, and that Jesus was the Father praying to Himself when He prayed and all this, whatever. They take that text from Acts chapter 2, I believe it's verse 38, where Peter says, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remissions of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Now what Peter, the emphasis there is he said to repent. He was talking to Israelites who were already in the Father. They had already been baptized in the Father. They were already Israelites. They were already in a covenant with the Father. So what were they doing? They were fulfilling their relationship with God. As a Jewish people who become Christians, they call it to become fulfilled or to finish their relationship with the Lord by adding the Lord Jesus Christ. For Jewish people who were already active Jews, that is where you see this text would match and be interpreted. And using proper biblical interpretation, they would be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because they're acknowledging that, yes, He's the Messiah. We already have a covenant with God, the Old Testament. We're acknowledging Jesus is that Messiah of God. But for Gentiles who are strangers and aliens of the nation of Israel, and the commonwealth of Israel, and are enemies of God, and have no relationship with God, and no covenant or nothing, then we come to God, and we're baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. We don't have, we're not, no relationship with God outside until through Jesus Christ. That's the difference, and that's rightly dividing the Word of God. I've got another video to make, the first one I was going to make, and I just, you know, the Lord jumped me on that one. Let me make this other one. I'll be right back.